Hello everyone, this is a 4-week MDP on use of ICT in education for online and blended learning. It is AICT Avru Faculty Development Program. I, Namrata Saxena, Assistant Professor, Electronics and Communication Engineering Department, Purnima College of Engineering, Jaipur. The topic of my today's presentation is stability. The learning outcomes of this presentation are, first, make and interpret a basic route table to determine the stability of a system. Second, make and interpret a route table where either the first element of a row is 0 or an entire row is 0. We can categorize stability among three categories: stable system, unstable system, and marginally stable system. A linear time invariant system is stable if the natural response approaches 0 as time approaches infinity. A system is unstable if the natural response grows without bound as time approaches infinity. A system is said to be marginally stable if the natural response neither decays nor grows but remains constant or oscillates as time approaches infinity. How to determine system stability? Let us focus on the natural response definitions of stability. A system is said to be stable if the closed loop poles lie on the left half of S plane, or if a system is said to be unstable if the roots lie on the right half of S plane, that is, poles lie on the right half of S plane, that is, have positive real part. Rao-Hurwitz stability criterion. It is the simplest method for determining the continuous system stability. The Rao-Hurwitz criterion states that the number of roots of the characteristic equation with positive real parts is equal to the number of changes in the sign of the first column of the Routh array. Let us consider the characteristic equation of nth order continuous system, that is given as an sn plus an minus 1 sn minus 1 plus a1 s plus a0 and so on equal to 0. The stability criterion is applied using a route table, which is defined as, first we write all powers of S, that is Sn, Sn minus 1 and so on. Then we write the coefficients from the characteristic equation of first two rows. From Sn, for Sn we write An, An minus 2, An minus 4 and so on. For Sn minus 1 we write An minus 1, An minus 3, An minus 5 and so on. Next we simply write B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3. Now we calculate B1 as An minus 1 into An minus 2 minus An into An minus 3 divided by An minus 1. And similarly we calculate the other coefficients. Let us take an example for generating a basic route table. This is the system of s to the power 4, s to the power 3, s to the power 2, 1 and s to the power 0. Only the first two rows of array are obtained from the characteristic equation. The remaining are calculated as follows. First we write all powers of s, s to the power 4, s to the power 0, s to the power 2, s to the power 1 and s to the power 0. The coefficients corresponding to s to the power 4 are a4, a2 and a0. The coefficients corresponding to s to the power 3 are a3, a1 and 0. The b1 can be calculated as minus mod of a4, a2, a3, a1 divided by a3. And similarly we calculate the other coefficients. There are four special cases or configurations in the first column array of the Routh table, out of which we are considering only first two cases for this presentation. Case 1. No element in the first column is 0. Let us consider a second order system, which is given as a2s square plus a1s plus a0. The Routh array can be formed as s2, s1 and s0. And the coefficients are a2, a0, a1, 0 and b1, 0. The b1 can be calculated as a1, into a naught minus a2 into 0 divided by a1. So it is again equal to a naught. Let us also consider the third order system. In this, the b1 can be calculated as a2 a1 minus a3 a0 divided by a2. The c1 can be calculated as b1 a0 minus a2 into 0 divided by b1. So it is equal to a0. And the requirement for a stable third order system is that the coefficient be positive. That is, a2 a1 should always be greater than a0 a3. Then the system is stable. For marginally stable, these two terms are equal. Let us consider one example. S cube plus 6s square plus 12s plus 8 equal to 0. This is the given characteristic equation. First, we write all powers of S, that is S0, S2, S1 and S0. The coefficients corresponding to S cube are 1, 12 and 0. The coefficients corresponding to S2 are 6, 8 and 0. Similarly, we calculate the first coefficient of S1 as 6 into 12, that is 72 minus 8 divided by 6. So, it becomes 64 upon 6. Next is 0 and the first coefficient of S0 is 8. And from this Routh table, we conclude that there is no sign change in the first column of Routh table. Hence, the system is stable. Let us consider one more example. S cube plus S square plus 2S plus 24 equal to 0. We can simply write as equal to 0. First, we write all powers of S. S cube, S square, S1 and S0. The first row corresponds to S cube have coefficients as 1, 2. S square has 1 and 24. The S1 coefficient can be calculated as 1 into 2 minus 1 into 24 divided by 1. So, it is equal to minus 22. The second coefficient is 0 and the first coefficient of S0 row is minus 22 into 24 minus 0 upon minus 22. So, it becomes 24. As there are two sign changes in the first column, so we find that the two poles of the closed loop system lie in the right half of S plane. Thus, the system is unstable. Similarly, we can take one more example in which we simply find the range of K by first forming the Routh array and thus simply say that the first column should be equal greater than 0. So, 8 minus K should be greater than 0 for the system to be stable and 1 plus K should be greater than 0. The range of K values of system parameter K must lies between minus 1 and 8. That is, K should be greater than minus 1 and less than 8. Case second, a 0 only in the first column. There are two methods in case 2, but we are considering only first method for this presentation. The first method is stability via epsilon method. If the first element of a row is 0, division by 0 would require to form the next row. To avoid this phenomenon, an epsilon, a small positive number, is assigned to replace the 0 in the first column. The value epsilon is then allowed to approach 0 from either the positive or negative side, after which the sign of the entries in the first column can be determined. Let us take one example. The characteristic equation is given as this. First, we write all powers of S from S5 to S0. The coefficients can be written as 1, 2 and 11. For the second row, it is 2, 4 and 10. As we see that, if we calculate the first element of S cube row, it is 2 into 2, that is 4 minus 4. that is 0. 0 upon anything is 0. So, we replace this 0 by epsilon. And the next elements we write similarly in the same manner. So, we calculate the C1 as 4 into epsilon minus 2 into 6 divided by epsilon. And D1 as 6 into C1 minus 10 into epsilon divided by C1, that is equal to 6. As there are two sign changes due to the large negative number in the first column, C1 equal to minus 12 by epsilon, therefore the system is said to be unstable. Similarly, we can also find the range of K from this, and we determine that the system is also unstable in this case also. Thank you and have a nice day.